I was debating what to write for National Interest this week. The old saying in American journalism is, when you're short of ideas, write about Afghanistan. That's also called Afghanistanism in American media. So in India, Afghanistan is a bit far. When you're short of ideas, you write about Pakistan. So I was thinking of writing something about Pakistan, an election has taken place. But really, I wasn't quite sure what can I say that hasn't been said before, and frankly, which I haven't said before. So instead of writing one more on Pakistan, I was searching for something, and then I saw this tweet by Rahul Gandhi that wished Uddhav Thackeray a happy birthday. So I said, hang on, Rahul Gandhi wishing Uddhav Thackeray a happy birthday, just check. Has it ever happened before that the president of the Congress party wished the chief of Shiv Sena, the party it most dislikes and most disagrees with, on his birthday? And if he does so, there has to be a political message there. So, spark came, and that then became Pakistan Was Spared, another lecture this weekend on National Interest, and a new understanding of politics emerged, provoked by this little tweet. Because if Rahul Gandhi is trying to reach out to Shiv Sena, the party more contrary to his own party's ideology, even more contrary than the BJP, it means several things. One, it means in politics, enemies your friend is common knowledge. But in this case, it means that he has decided that the enemy is so much an enemy, that is the Modi Shah BJP, that he will even try and strike friendship with the enemy's friend. It breaks or challenges many essential tenets of Indian politics. One tenet, something that Mr. Advani used to teach us, and I refer to that in the column, is that if you are building a coalition, there are some parties you can never go with. And there are some parties who have no choice but to go with you. So he used to say, 88 onwards, that BJP will go with any party but five, which call the BJP anti-national. These five were Congress, the left, Lalu Yadav's RJD, Mulayam's SP, Samajwadi Party, and the Muslim League. And today you can say the likes of Muslim League, which is Oasis, MIM, or Badruddin Ajmal's AUDF. Besides these, he said the BJP will go with anybody. And then it followed that there were parties which had no choice but to go with the BJP. Foremost among them were the Akali Dal in Punjab and Shiv Sena, because they are essentially religious parties. They cannot go with a secular formulation. And third, he thought, was Telugu Desam Party, simply because its only adversary in that state was the Congress. This Rahul tweet makes us think if this has changed, because one essential ally of the BJP is now estranged, Shiv Sena. You have to be nuts today to think that Shiv Sena could join the UPA tomorrow, or that Congress party will go and embrace the Shiv Sena as a political ally. Openly, this is most unlikely to happen. But if Rahul Gandhi can keep Shiv Sena away from NDA, then all bets are off in Maharashtra. Both sides now acknowledge, Congress as well as the BJP. BJP will not say it in public, but they all tell you that nobody is expecting at this point, ceteris paribus, as economists say, all things remaining the same, nobody is expecting at this point the 2014 majority to be repeated. There will be a coalition built in 2019, all things remaining the same as today. In that situation, we are back to what I used to call in the past, and you can refer to earlier National Interests on this, the best of nine sets tennis match theory of Indian politics, which means Indian politics like a best of nine sets tennis match. What are these sets? These are UP, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Maharashtra, nine big states where change can take place. So we don't count West Bengal, we don't count Gujarat, because we didn't expect change to take place there. Now, these nine states, and we include in these states old Andhra, which includes Telangana, they pack about 350 seats in national parliament. Any side that wins five of the nine states automatically gets to 160 plus, and in fact close to 200. That is the new 272 in Indian politics. Because then others will come in. There are many parties who will join anybody who's forming a coalition in power, irrespective of ideology. The Dravid parties are among those. Kumaraswamy's party in Karnataka is among those. So the fact is, one, that we are back to that situation, that you're back to best of nine sets. Now, if the BJP is not going to do well in Uttar Pradesh, because Samajwadi Party and BSP come together, if they come together, there is no way BJP will repeat its success of 73. In fact, it will struggle even to get halfway to that. Remember, the second largest state in India by way of its contribution to Lok Sabha is Maharashtra. That's 48. Now, if Shiv Sena stays out of NDA, then BJP, although Amit Shah has lately been saying he's been rallying his party to fight Maharashtra alone, but he knows it, and everybody knows it, that if Shiv Sena is not part of the alliance, then all bets are off in Maharashtra. So if BJP can't repeat its numbers in UP and Maharashtra, it's bound to suffer attrition in Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. Then a different outcome in this election is likely. That is what Rahul Gandhi is aiming at. So now the picture is becoming much clearer leading up to 2019. Two pointers we have to think about. One, of course, is Rahul Gandhi's love note, public love note to Uddhav Thackeray. And second, play back Mr. Modi's reply to the no confidence motion. It's a point that many of us missed that day. But if you play it again, you will see where he's being critical of Chandrababu Naidu. He's being so flattering and so complimentary of K. Chandrasekhar Rao, the Chief Minister of Telangana. Remember also that it's KCR who's been trying to put together a front of various state leaders to rule Delhi tomorrow. You can call it the federal front or whatever, but he's the one who took the lead. So Mr. Modi is now reaching out to him. So just as Congress party is trying to deny Mr. Modi the advantage in Maharashtra, he's trying to make up for some of that by finding new allies in what used to be Andhra, because it is now split. So this is how the game is now playing out. I would still say it's the initial few overs of what's going to be a very exciting match. But the order of battle is now pretty much becoming clear.